Hey everyone, Jakey Stoltz here with Skydio's regulatory team. I've got an exciting regulatory update to share in the public safety space. So earlier this month, Pasco County Sheriff's Office in Florida received a Part 107 waiver to conduct remote operations without visual observers. Now we've been unlocking remote ops without VOs for some time now with commercial customers, but this approval represents the first time for public safety where Pasco County is now able to operate remotely without visual observers, without any flight crew on site, up to 200 feet AGL or within 50 feet of structures, and importantly, just with ADSB technology. So no other additional airspace awareness technology is required. So let's talk a little bit about that safety case. And when we talk safety case, we always talk about air and ground risk, and usually the multiple layers in each one of those. So for air risk, Pasco County is located in a Mode C veil of Tampa International Airport. And in this area, aircraft are required to broadcast ADS-B out unless they've received permission from the FAA to fly without it. And over a year ago now, Skydio began integrating ADS-B into remote flight deck. And this integration makes it really easy for pilots and operators to see where these aircraft are operating at in real time. And then if necessary, they're able to make decisions and give right away to those aircraft. And as I said, there's layers. So in addition to ADS-B technology, the operations are also conducted at lower altitudes. It's within 200 feet AGL or within 50 feet of structures. And so operating at a bit lower altitudes gives a little more buffer between the drone operations and the lowest altitudes where crewed aircraft typically operate. Now ground risk, that's managed by operating at Pasco County Sheriff's Office first facility, as well as Pasco County schools. And so operations initially will be used for things like training and responding to events within the school properties. But we expect that as our parachute attachment for X10 starts shipping later this year, Pasco County will be able to expand this waiver into a full drone as first responder approval, or DFR. If you want to learn more about this regulatory strategy, you can watch a pre-recorded video now of a June 13th webinar, where I explained our regulatory approach to unlocking DFR operations at scale. But for now, we want to give a congratulations to Pasco County Sheriff's Office in reaching this no visual observer milestone. We're really excited for the impact this approval will have in Pasco County, but also what it represents for public safety more broadly as we get closer and closer to unlocking drone as first responder without VOs at scale. So that's all I have for now. We'll see you next time and fly safe.